10-4.
Well, fuck it. 10-4, world's coolest scooter podcast right now.
Scooter podcast.
Hottest shit
planet.
Out. If you ain't know,
stop
you
playing.
Sleeping. Get the fuck up out your hibernation. We got my man, Swamp Daddy, coming in hot. He's here. You see him. We skulled up.
In the place.
We drippy.
But,
how you been? Bro. What brings you out here?
Yeah, well, I came out here to film with y'all.
Yeah, yeah.
I ain't been really, like, going on too many trips recently. I'm trying to get some clips in and make some shit happen, really. Got a few clips in.
Holler at him if you will sponsor watching this.
If you want to sponsor a real true gangster, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, God.
Holler at your boy. But if not, it don't matter. You know what I'm saying? But I got about 14 clips.
Yeah.
On
the world
Matt's
hasn't seen enough Josiah footage lately, man.
Yeah, I've only
Feels
had
nice
like
to get one, back in the works.
One video, and it was kind of shitty because I didn't know how to use the DVX-100B because that shit's complicated as fuck. And if you know how to use a real fucking VX or whatever, you're a true gangster because I'm ignorant.
Those tapes are such a bitch, dude.
Facts. Can't fuck with them like that.
It looks cool, like if you're filming on the East Coast, like a nice SD video, but like...
Got the East crust in the background, it's nice.
HD for sure.
Which could never had to figure out how to focus them shits. But yeah, I got a few clips around in like BR and Colorado with like y'all.
Yep.
And...
Just from solid. Brother trips, man.
Yeah, just from brother trips. Like, I got a bunch of clips out here in Austin, Texas, holding it down. The city of them swangers, whatever y'all want to call them. You know what I'm saying?
We swing and bang.
They stay swinging right here, I swear.
Oh,
I don't see them drifting too much, but
R.I.P.
they be swinging on them bitches.
Robert Earl Davis.
Right. Whoever the hell that is. But
I don't know either.
Shout out DJ Screw. Yeah. Most of y'all only know him as DJ Screw, but that's all right.
Oh, God. But yeah, man. We just finna,
gonna do the damn thing.
How does it feel holding down that Louisiana scooter scene, being the king of swamp ass out there?
Oh, shit.
It's a heavy crown, it must be.
It used to be popping. Like, used to have, like, Jamie, Dakota Dawkins. Shout out the
Jim
boy.
Jim Pants. Shout out Jim Pants.
Jamie Gans.
Shout out Jamie Gans.
Oh, my God.
I do that every time he gets in my live.
Shout out Benton.
For no reason.
Benton, Hobbister, Truck Nuts. 420 on Instagram.
Oh, he shut
out my
just,
boy.
Not even just, like
God.
6 months ago, maybe moved to my area.
Yeah.
Still haven't got a sesh with them though.
Yeah, I'm trying to come see you boy on the spring break, but it feels, I mean, shit, it's kind of like boring at sometimes because like not a lot of people just want to keep on like riding and like go, because I go out every day basically after I get off work or most of the time if I'm not too busy, but.
I feel like we kind of have some of the same, like, story in that aspect. It's like, a lot of our homies have, like, came in and rode at some points, but they've always, like, just fallen off, and it's a lot of solo sessions.
Facts, bro. I be solo session like a motherfucker. If you ever see my Instagram videos, it's probably some 10-year-old kid behind the camera. Was that good? I'm like, fuck. I mean, I guess. In
It'll
my
work.
Video, too, I'm like, say, bro. I'm up, you know what I'm saying? I teach him, I like show him how to zoom in and stuff, like 15, 20 minutes, show him how to focus it kinda, but I barely know how to do that shit. It'll end up just looking like a film of a fucking baked potato.
I see you putting on the little homies though. Shout out little Stinky.
Shout out Stinky, ooh, shout out Colton. Stinky.
What's that one fool, Crowns?
Shout out Crowns, man fucking fired the crack. Man firecracker at 18 like a boss.
Oh,
dropped in on it his first attempt.
God.
Indeed.
Wow.
Go watch the Brothers
so
Street Jam video
sick.
From this year in Austin.
Yeah.
This dude dropped into an 18 scale.
Literally going fast as shit.
Literally hit the last two. I don't know how he can't get knocked the fuck out. But yeah, shout out all
of them. God. But I would never try that shit.
Yeah, Louisiana.
Nobody has ever tried that shit.
Louisiana's got a big skate scene. It's got a pretty big fucking bike scene, BMX scene. But scooters ain't really never been popping off there like that.
But same here, bro.
Same. I feel like where all of us grew up, we were kind of riding by ourselves for the most part.
Yeah. But
shout out my water bottle.
keeps you happy though at the end of the
ultimate
day.
Filmer.
Facts. Indeed. Fuck them tripod. Always there for me. Always broke my tripod raging. You know what I'm saying?
Just throwing that bitch. Is the raging Cajun a correct stereotype?
It just depends on how many brewskis you throwing back or not with me.
God. Like,
if I'm on some Red Bull by vodka, you know what I'm saying? You better watch the fuck out. That's all I'm saying. But I'm just playing. But shit.
Nah, we know what the truth is.
Shout out Ruckus, even though they don't fucking like me, and half the skaters at my skate park don't fuck with me. Or I don't know, some of them don't fuck with me, but shout out them boys that don't fuck with me. Haters are my motivator. You know what I'm saying?
Retweet. Amen.
But most of them are cool. All the Ruckus team is cool. I think they fuck with me. I spend a lot of money at your store, so.
Yeah, bro.
You better.
Tap us, them in.
Let's scooter riders be some.
Let me get on Ruckus. Let me be the first scooter rider to get on Ruckus, god damn it. But, yeah. I'd be the only scooter rider on the team. Like, why the fuck is this kid here?
Just give me shoes.
What is he doing? Ooh, that'd be some shit.
I can see it though. Yeah, I can see you pulling up just like how you're looking.
Check this fool out. He's got a funny voice and he goes
just
big.
One scooter. On God.
Like, damn.
On God, he's a diamond in the rough.
Absolutely.
But shout out. I know I started riding because fucking. I seen Dakota riding shit a lot. So shout out Dakota.
Like really? Online or like at your skate park or what?
DAK47, I like, miss you.
So I got a scooter when I was like fucking 12 or no, 13. And I was just pushing around my neighborhood. Me and my friend, we built a fucking half pipe in the backyard of his house or whatever. And then we just like, oh yeah, they got the skate park. It's like 20 minutes away. So I pulled up there. And then, just seen Dakota and shit. I was like, damn, what the fuck is he doing? I didn't really think people would do that shit like that.
Yeah, it was cold with it.
Yeah, I was like, what the hell? But yeah. And Jamie, of course. I got like a little Razor scooter when I was like 13. Pulled up to the park.
Pro model?
Yeah. Man, it was just session. Hitting fucking backflips. Like, down the fucking rails to double whip and shit.
Shout out Jim Pants. Fucking gangsta. For real.
Oh, what you looking for?
Gangsta, man.
What you need? Oh, this? Oh, I got you. Come on, say what up. Come in the camera.
Say what up.
What it is, Josh. Come on.
What up, y'all?
Come on, tell them what the red is.
Y'all see this mullet.
It's your boy, Local Scum. You'll see me later.
You'll see him later.
It's your boy, Dumps the Dick.
He's
on the camera.
Active. He has been super active today. Shout out Josh real quick. He was stomping tricks at the park with us tonight.
A scummy ass man.
He's probably got one of the steeziest double whips in the game.
For real.
Can't fuck with him. Oh God, we'll throw that clip in there.
Got you, bro. That man's too scummy.
Let me get the airdrop right now.
Worst thing is he didn't even film it. It was just like first try and shit, you know.
Yep.
He's like, I'm gonna bust it. Bust it up.
Double ups are tough, man.
You'll see clips of him. We filmed some clips of him today. Yeah. Clean ass bar 50.
He got active bar 50 on a 5x23 long. It's a fucking pencil deck of a scooter deck.
Y'all don't even know. Y'all don't even know. My boy treats this shit like it's 2016 still.
Right. The fuck?
Stuck in it.
He don't need no big
TSI. Thing. Send us a Zenith for him. Tap him in. He's ready for it. Ready for it.
Let me know when y'all
the
gonna sponsor Josh.
The world would literally go crazy if Josh Fuller wrote a 6 or wider. That would be tight.
Thanks. Yeah.
Shout out TSI. Shout out.
Yeah, shout out who makes some good parts these days?
Native.
Shout out Affinity. Actually.
Native makes the best scooter deck shout in out, scootering.
Shout out to them boys, Affinity.
You heard it here first.
So yeah, shout out Proto. What'd you say?
Native Scooters has the best decks.
Native does
industry.
Have the best decks. In my
opinion.
And I have to say.
Never read one.
Native. Right. Probably fucking, I really like my North deck, even though I broke like 2 or 3 of them, but they're still sick. And
Mother
I really like,
right now.
Good. Yeah, I really like the Urban Art decks too. Those feel crazy. Those
are you fire. Just got those on are a Proto.
Heard those are
a Proto? Yeah, the Proto's like sick. It. I really want an Urban Art though, so I kind of pulling me like back and forth. Like, fuck, I don't know. Cause like I hopped on an Urban Art the other day. I was just like, fucking, you could do anything on that bit. Weird.
You can always get it. Yeah. Just, you know, have them both.
Fact. But the proto feels good. I like it for grinds. It feels really good. Kind of hard to throw around.
Grinds, it's heavy.
It's pretty fucking hard to throw around. If you're doing fucking any type of full whip tricks, like combo tricks, you're a fucking G on the proto.
Bro, the shit Tyrese does on that deck is silly.
Oh, God. Shout out Tyrese. Shout out the boys.
He's silly. He'll be on here.
Yeah, he will definitely is.
Shout out Reese for multiple things.
For real. Fucking legend.
Captain,
that's a little true ass role model. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? That's a whole role that's model.
Big bro.
For real. That's
big bro.
But yeah. Shout out Patrick Foster.
Did you go to, were you in New York with all of them as well?
Yeah, I went to New York. Ooh, I didn't get shit, but I was
eating chopped cheeses.
I was eating chopped cheeses, fucking shit. I mostly got like some barbecue chicken sandwiches, really. I'm like, damn, I didn't know they had delis out there. Like, around my house, it's just like fucking, they'll have like crawfish and shit at the fucking gas stations.
Is it good?
It's just like weird.
Like, would you kinda eat similar. It?
Yeah, I'd eat crawfish crawfish from a gas station.
Because like, we got some food in our gas stations here that like, for me saying it doesn't sound good. Yeah. Sometimes it's actually pretty foul.
Nah, if you go to Louisiana, Brother's Chicken, you gotta hit that up.
Brothers,
you gotta hit.
Let's go as brothers.
You chicken. Go to any type of gas station in Louisiana, basically, they're probably gonna have some good chicken and good food in that bitch.
They got crawfish in the gas stations there?
They be having crawfish pies.
Twisted?
They got crawfish pies. Yeah, they got all types of twisted shit. They got like them crown drinks. Shit. They got like a
Coke
whole.
And crown in a can.
Yeah, they got like a whole big ass selection of just like, they got, you know, there's Texas got them too, but like. It's like just that back room with a freezer, and it's got all types of fucking alcohol, and shit. They got like drive-through daiquiri shops at the gas station.
I know, but the both of us are trying to pull up and come to a crawfish boil.
Oh yeah, y'all gonna have to pull up. It's crawfish season, bitch.
You suck the head.
It's got. I don't suck the head like that, but I definitely. I don't know. I have before. I got a video of me fucking chewing the fuck out of a crawfish head somewhere in my phone. But
how many brewskis?
I don't normally drink beer and eat crawfish. I just fucking veg out on crawfish. We be putting like hot dogs, anything you could think of that's like meat in the fucking thing. Not really anything, but hot dogs, sausage, corn. Gator. I ain't never put gator in there, but I have ate a bacon wrapped gator. That shit was
thick as fuck.
That bitch was like in a smoker. And
damn.
I think the weirdest thing I ate was probably fucking bull balls. That's y'all shit. That's some
bull
Texas
balls?
Shit. Yeah, you know that mountain oysters?
Yeah.
Yeah, they be like looking like chicken nuggets. My dad fucking had a big ass plate on.
Oh, I have never had a bull sack.
Nah, I mean, it was good. I probably ate by like 10 of them. No homo. no homo. Shit, but I just live like that. I eat frog legs. Shit. I eat frog legs. Fucking. I cooked. Bro. Like when I was a kid, I used to go fucking get me some frogs. Yeah. Like I used to, they had like big ass fucking bullfrogs. Josh and me was talking about that earlier.
Yeah, how big are these fucking frogs?
Shit.
Bro, you damn can get that a big. Fat ass bullfrog.
Long as your
sometimes,
arm,
bro.
For real.
God,
yeah, things bust up.
We'll show y'all some pictures. I'll drop a pic right here.
When you when you think you snatched your first frog?
I started doing when I was like 11 or probably like 10 or 11. And we would like go and like kill eels, get frogs, kill snakes, all types of shit. Like kill alligator gar. Like we had this big ass spear. Kind of look like some fucking Aquaman shit.
Spearing them bitches.
Yeah. Like real it's shit. Impressive. Get some more. Like,
I've seen a lot of like Man versus Wild. Yeah. That type show in these films. Oh, God. Spear for shit.
Yeah. Y'all ever, shout out Swamp People. I used to fucking love that show as a kid.
Yeah,
you ever seen Swamp People?
Oh, yeah. Me and Josh be watching that.
Dude,
that's funny as hell.
Is that based in Louisiana?
Yeah.
It goes around the
Shout out my boy Shelby the Swamp Man. If you don't know who Shelby the Swamp Man is, go look him up on YouTube because that's probably the craziest motherfucker on YouTube.
See them leeches right there? Suck the blood out your ass.
You gotta brush your teeth when you get
here.
What's sucking on the. Oh. Oh, yeah.
How you like that? How you like that one, don't you?
Now I gotta brush my teeth.
I lived in the swamp all my life. Everything I need, the swamp provides, man. Hold on! Oh my God! Ow!
We're going to the powder bars, but sure enough, there's a damn alligator floating in the river. I gotta get them teeth, man.
That's the real Swamp Daddy. Like, I'm telling y'all. If you want to see some crazy ass shit, man, literally bites the head off snakes and shit. Like venomous snakes. Yeah. He'll like be catching venomous snakes and the bitches will just be biting them all over. That guy's like fucking catching them and shit. Oh, yeah. It'd be like fucking, I can't even explain. You're just going to have to go peep them out. For real.
I feel like you've showed me them before.
Yeah, I definitely have. We had definitely been fucking sauced and watched Show with the Swamp Man. We definitely going to put some B-roll on Show with the Swamp Man in my video. For real. Be down.
It's crazy. I didn't know there was an OG Swamp Daddy, though.
No, that's the OG right
there.
That's
the OG, okay.
For real. You ain't, like, I'm sorry.
You were my OG before that, man.
Yeah.
OG Swamp Daddy.
Yeah, nah. That's
the real Swamp. He's paying respect. Okay. That's respect. Yeah.
You have respect. I was, like, my idol as a kid, bro. That Swamp People shit.
He's, like, the Steve Irwin.
Yeah.
Louisiana.
That motherfucker crazier than Steve Irwin. You don't got shit on Show with the Swamp Man. I'm just gonna let you know that now. Cause shit, he got hit by one stingray, bro. This dude getting bit by like fucking 10 different types of snakes. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Oh man,
one stingray got his ass.
That's facts, bro. I mean, took the easy way out. Can't cap.
Shit, shout out to him. I did used to watch Discovery Channel shit as a kid. I did fuck with Steve Irwin.
For real. Him. Rest in peace. At the end of the day, like, you were a G, Steve.
That's a true OG right there.
R.I.P. Pimp C.
Back. R.I.P. Boozilla.
R.I.P. Boozilla. R.I.P. Foe and them.
You think Boosie's got the best rap snacks, Chip? Think he's holding it down?
I think the Migos have better fucking...
Damn.
They got some all types on that. You know what I'm saying? Boosie's all right. Them bitches is too hot.
But yeah. I don't know.
Boosie the real OG. I don't know if y'all ever seen Kevin Gates drinks, though. He got like them IDGTs. It's just a fucking Red Bull with the Kevin Gates label on it. It ain't nothing special.
It's more expensive, too.
Yeah. Don't waste your money on it. But yeah, shout out Kevin Gates.
Fell off, bro. He's kind of mid now.
Like real shit. That man's homo. You look up on YouTube, like they be talking about is doing him in the butt in prison and shit. Like I used to fuck with Kevin Gates back as a kid, but like,
yeah.
I don't know now. But not anything like it's gay people or anything. But like, he was just taken to a different level. Like he was like raping dudes and shit in jail. Apparently, like damn, like I'm like damn, bro.
You don't fuck if you're gay, but
actually,
real shit.
If you're a rapist, you're a rapist.
Oh, that's what I heard. I could be wrong, but
fucking, he's got two phones.
How can a nigga stick their whole hand in a nigga purse, in a nigga ass? I said, come on, let's go. Me and him roll. Bing, 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 bing. I dapped him off. I said, I respect you, homie. Come on, let's do it again.
Shit, if that was me, I'd be like, damn, what the fuck? You know what I mean?
Yo, Kevin Gates raped me in prison.
Is that a flex?
I couldn't.
Try to flex. Yeah, I was prison fool, just got out. Yeah, fucking.
Yo, I really don't get tired.
Yeah,
man.
What else you got planned for this year, JoJo? Where else you trying to go? What street jams you trying to hit?
Trying to come to Austin, Texas Jam, of course.
9th annual Wave Jam.
Yeah, wave. If you ain't got a rag on, then you might as well not even throw tricks. Yeah. Let's just be real. I'm just kidding.
Oh God, we're gonna pull up with a box of them.
We're definitely gonna pull up
with a box of them for people to put on.
We're getting two.
We gotta get a variety pack of them bitches, like variety all pack. Colors of the rainbow.
Oh God, show love.
Nah, but Austin, I want to go to Denver Jam. I want to go to New York Jam if they have one of them hoes. I want to come to Havasu with you guys. That would be sick. I'm trying to go to Vegas and see the fucking fake ass Eiffel Tower. You know what I'm saying?
I would go to Vegas again.
Yeah.
Just to play some roulette. Oh God.
I got bad blood with Vegas, man.
And Florida. Gotta go back to Florida. I'm definitely going to Miami this summer with my old lady. Yeah. Shout out my baby.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh,
yeah,
gosh.
Swamp Mama. You know what I mean?
She holding it down for the
she
boy.
She holds it down for me. I ain't lying. She'll be at the skate park. I'll be fucking like out at the skate park for 4 hours. I probably won't talk to her one time, but I'll come back in the car and she'll still be sitting in the car with no problem. You know what I'm saying? Like, damn. Yeah, she's just reading a book. I'm like, damn, you a whole gangster.
That's
you
know pimp. Yeah. All right. Yeah. Shout out Swamp Mama. Yeah, she holds it down for our boy.
She's holding it down. That's my sugar
mama. That's a bet. Yeah, that's tight, honestly, because, yeah, I've definitely taken some girls to the park, and they're just, like, getting annoyed, like, if you're gone and not talking to them. It's like, what the fuck?
Yeah, no, they'll offer to film clips until your 10 tries in.
Yeah, she gets aggravated. I'll be like, you gonna keep filming? You gonna keep filming? She's like, I'll be having trouble with that sometimes. I ain't lying. Like, when the camera come out, I'm pretty camera shy, but, like, off camera, like, I'll stick shit. Like, I don't know, I'm pretty bad
about that. I feel that. Every time the camera comes out, that shit comes. It just takes.
That's why you gotta ride off like one tall boy.
Yeah,
loosen you up
for real. Then you go back and
done wonders for my riding career in the past few months.
Yeah,
just loose.
I see that my son Austin be posted up on Snapchat with a Twisted Tea every day. Twisted Tea, we talked about this last night.
What is up?
What the fuck is you doing?
Tap in with the sponsorship.
You don't want to put our faces
on. This dude can backflip. Like, you know what I'm saying? Fuck.
Shit, I'll do another flare if I have to.
No, you won't.
For some Twisted Tees. If they're like, we could sponsor you if you could flare. Yeah, I'm fucking looking over my shoulder again. On God.
I'd love to see it.
For real.
All right, tap in with Twisted.
What about you, though, Paxton? When you going back to Florida, bro?
Shit, man, I was just there. It was my mama and my sister's birthday. Same weekend, 18 and 50.
Paxton, low-key from the swamp, too. Like, the swamp.
Fuck,
Florida,
man.
Got a big-ass swamp as well.
Nothing compared to Louisiana, but I grew up on the water.
Yeah, Paxton, where Paxton lives is, like, gangster as fuck. They got all types of shit out there.
Bro, I'm...
You'll literally spend your life savings at where Paxton lives, if you're a drunk.
Yeah, if you're faded and in Destin.
If you're a drunk and you like to drive a boat.
Definitely blowing some capital.
Huh?
Fucking, dude, I met you there at my local, like, 2015.
That shit is Niceville, crazy.
Niceville, Florida. That is crazy.
And I still can't believe, like, we both still ride scooters. It's weird.
I know.
I think I met Pax. No. What Austin gym did I meet you at? I'm pretty sure the first one I went to.
Whichever one that one was, I'm pretty sure I remember meeting, like,
the first one I
Dakota.
Went to was when, like, Michael Holman did that bar, or no, he did, like, a switch
front board. Down the goblin. Yeah. I mean, honestly, I can't
shout out
even
that
tell
crazy
you. That
ass
was, like,
motherfucker.
Maybe year three, year four, like,
yeah,
year two. No,
I don't even remember.
That's crazy, though. I would never have seen this coming.
For real, bro.
We're going to use too much sauce in the next Instavid. First Instavid we ever made.
Right.
Too much sauce.
We use a whole different section of it, so it's going to be really sauced out.
Shout out to Future.
Shout out to Future, the toxic king.
Yeah.
Who else we shouting out? Shit, we got like probably 20 deep, right?
Yes. We got a whole bunch of Florida people. Shout out everybody from the South.
Everybody,
some of you Yankees are cool.
Favorite thing to do in Destin when you're there.
Favorite thing to do in Destin is ride jet skis and go out past the harbor. Like, go out past where, like, the waves. The buoys. Yeah, that's what they call them. Yeah, we go out past the buoys. We fucking, like, ramp them bitches like we in GTA.
Yeah! Cut out! Yeah, probably, but I ain't finna pull your phone out because I'm doing the dash. So you better hold on. Cause we doing, I gotta get at least up to 7. Holy shit! Can't even hold my phone, bro.
I got some GTA shit for real, but
full charge.
Yeah, Destin is fun as fuck. Like, you could, they got like tiki boats. You'll get fucking drunk as shit out on a boat, like in the middle of Crab Island.
Oh, Crab Island! Shout out,
dude! You can get on Crab Island, just like fucking swim around, go anywhere, find a fucking sand dollar, fucking get some snails.
Put them in your pocket.
Get some berries. Oh, fuck. What else they got? They got banana boats.
Fucking
them
Trump
is crazy
flags
as fuck.
Titties.
Yeah, Trump flags. They got buku Trump flags out there. Buku. Shit. Like, literally every car you look at, they got a Trump flag on it. Every gas pump, they got the Biden did that sticker.
Yep.
Yeah, dude. Every gas station I pull up by my house, they got that shit. I'm like, bro, what the fuck? Where y'all getting these bitches from? Y'all really spend your money on this shit? The fuck?
And then, like, half the time, you'll have the other crazy-ass fucking people that just be ripping him off, so all that's left there is, like, half his head. And he's just, like, did that. I don't know.
Fuck it.
Shout out all of the South.
Shit, bro. You're one of the most enjoyable people to have behind a megaphone at a street jam. I don't know what it is, but you can get motherfuckers to just throw themselves. With
I was hyping them up for real.
They don't give a fuck what happens to them if Swamp Daddy's calling their tricks, bro.
I'm like, if you want to make varsity, you better do that shit. Jacob hits like a fucking whip finger rip or some shit down that fat ass gap.
Homie Cody, two tone.
Two tone. Two tone was killing it.
Shout out two tone.
Yeah, Cody, you're a G.
Shout out everybody that came to the Austin Gym and steady comes to the Austin Gym. Been coming to Austin Gym for like
9th annual this next year, and then we got the Big 10 coming up.
Yeah.
I feel like, you know, 9's going to be nice. Y'all should come, but 10's the one.
10
is going to be fucking pimp, bro. Don't sleep on the 9th annual.
Absolutely not. Don't
sleep on the 9th annual. We're going to get fucking twisted.
Yep.
It's 3rd annual, I think, Terp Jam. Fucking
the Terp Jam last year wasn't really popping off like that. I'm not gonna lie.
I don't even know if
we actually did it. I was so drunk that whole day. Like, I think we just didn't do shit.
They had one homie that was just, never mind. I'm not gonna say that, but
can we talk? So, the first ever annual Terp Jam, this is the champion right here.
This is the champion of the
I think
Terp
he threw down a 3 gram dub.
Yeah, it was 3 grams.
Yeah, bro, I had a, like, 15-minute conversation with Matt by the time you started your dab, and you were still smoking that shit at the end of my conversation. It was like, we'd just, like, peek over, check in every once in a while. I was like, yeah, he's still hitting that shit.
Dude, Ian was, like, pushing me, too. Like, he kept talking shit. I was like, do you want to hit this shit? I'm like, do you want to hit this shit? I was like, do you think you hit this shit? He's like, nah, bro, you're good. Just keep going. That shit's, like, black by the time I'm done.
Dude, I swear at some point you inhaled a flame. Like, it was probably, so, bro. Like, he kept torching the fuck out
of
it.
Dude, I had to. It's like, I was trying, I don't know.
And then we set off the
fire alarm.
But we set off the fire alarm.
No, that was me and Caleb, though. Like, literally, Fool did not set the fire alarm off, hitting an 8.
I just love how, like,
me and Caleb hit 2.6s next to each other. Just
that's
fucking Fool. Literally, Ian literally dipped all the way back to Houston. Didn't look back, just ran out the door.
Like, dude was
like, he was out of there.
Yeah, bro. I jumped out. I fucking took out the back door and I jumped the fence. I thought we were trying to get in trouble for real. Because, like, they had too many people in that bitch. Like, you had, like, Matt and, like, Jamie and, like, all them back there. And then, like, fucking Matt Cobalt was Matt, shout out Matt Cobalt. Shout out Active Scooter, bro. But I was, like, sitting there and I was fucking hitting like, ripping that shit. Matt was like, bro, I got high sitting next to him. Bro, shout out Matt Coburn. That's the funniest motherfucker. Dude,
and during that Terp Jam, y'all were like, all right, yeah, we're going to go around the circle and drop like 0.25, and then the next go around we'll drop 0.5, and then a gram maybe. And I think we got through two homies. They did 0.5, and you're like, ah, fuck it, I'm going to drop 3 grams.
Yeah.
And then that was literally the end of the Terp Jam. It's just you. Literally.
I think I pissed some people off. I think I pissed some people off, but fuck it. I was like, why is he even going to do this? He's just trying to prove a point. But I was really just fucking vibing, bro. That shit was fun as fuck.
Yeah, that was like set in stone. He had bought the, like, he was like, bro, I'm going to do this. Like, I need this. And I'm like, all right, like, let's go. We'll get you right. We'll get it going. And like, yeah, if I was in his shoes, I would just want to do it. I don't want to wait around all night to hit this fat ass totally dab I'm trying to hit. Like,
it was crazy.
It's a power move. I want to hit it. Yeah.
Because, like, after I hit that shit, I was like, ate a bag of chips, drank some water, and I was good for the rest of the night until I got to your house and then passed out with my eyes open.
Yeah. I was going to say, I have a video of you slumped on the floor. Just like,
Like, at so the rest funny. Of the Terp Jam, like, I was good. Like, we came back inside, I think, huh? After the alarm went off.
Yeah.
And then that never happened.
Levi was like, it's chill.
Yeah.
Like, you know, we're all good. So we kept chilling for probably, like, hour or two after that. But Yeah, we didn't like really do the official Terp Jam after that. We were just chilling.
Yeah.
Taking dabs. We knew what was good. He got awarded the two custom active shirts.
I still got them.
Gifted me one.
Big smoke scootering.
Oh, yeah.
That shit is pimp.
Bro. My mom found that shit in the washer the other day. So she was like, what the hell is this? I was like, yeah, I found that at Goodwill.
My mama wins.
Big smoke scootering.
Listen.
That's my favorite t-shirt of all time that I have.
Yeah.
Sharpied on and everything. It's
yeah,
a relic.
Literally just sharpied on.
Fucking relic.
True hash.
Thanks.
Yeah, I try not to like wear it when I ride and shit because I don't want to put it through the washer. And like,
I put mine through the washer a good bit and that shit never came off.
Really?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that shit's on there.
I've always been scared. It's like, I don't want to fuck this thing up.
I think it'd be good.
But
for real.
Yeah, no, that's a bet. The gym.
So, Joe, you got anywhere in mind that you want to go to film? Is there anything, like, if you could go anywhere in the country right now, where do you want to go?
Or world,
yeah.
Where could we see a Swamp Daddy part?
We need the swamp around the world.
Probably Paris.
Paris?
I always rode Paris, like, on the fucking old-ass, like, skate Wii games and shit. And, like, for some reason, I always thought Paris was just, like, shit. You know what I'm saying?
Like, yeah.
But low-key, it's probably, like, whack as fuck out there. But I've always wanted to see the Eiffel Tower and go up to the top of that bitch and maybe smoke a blunt if I could.
Yeah, take Swamp Mama up there.
What flat trick you doing in front of the Eiffel Tower for the pick?
I'm doing probably fucking... maybe a triple whip, bro. I feel like that would be worthy enough. Just like cool, fast. Shout out Tyrese, man. Can fucking do him like...
You got a triple whip? You got a triple whip flat, Joe?
Definitely not on the pro, though. But I ain't built like that. I don't see how that man does it.
That's like, a master trick.
Like, I don't know if I've seen him do it on the
it's
six.
A power move.
Oh, no. He did it on the Aztec. He did it on my Aztec at the time.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. The 6.66, the Jake Sorensen one. He did that shit like first try. I was like, what the fuck? What is this dude, bro? Started feeling the skin.
I actually kind of gets me a little tight whenever I see someone do it that easily. Because it takes literally so much effort for me to just try it and not land it. It's like, goddamn.
I could do one on the old ass attic decks. Like, you know, I had like a Johan Moore attic deck. And I had a Matt McKean attic deck OG. I had the green attic deck. I had the blue one. I had all the attic decks. Fuck.
That's fire. I never rode one.
I still have in my room. I literally have probably 18 scooter decks in my room.
Damn. Really? Snapped or whole?
Yes, I swear. I'll send, like, I got pictures of them and everything. Some of them I had to get warranties on. But like, yeah, I spent like a lot of money on the decks. I got too many decks.
You be snapping them, huh?
Yeah.
How fast do you go through parts?
Not that fast. I mean, sometimes. It just depends on, like, if I'm fucking mobbing. Like, today I was, like, trying, but, like, I just, like, fucking up. And, like, my scooter's still good. I guess it's just shit. Depends on how hard it goes. I go through wheels. Like, I bet that's how it is for everyone, though.
Yeah.
Go through wheels like a motherfucker.
Enemy.
Yeah.
Look at the proto grippers, though. They've been treating me pretty well.
Bro, yeah, I remember two jams ago you snapped your fork at the very beginning of the jam. You had to, was it your fork? You broke some shit,
bro,
on your scooter.
I had the 6-watt, the Aztec 6-watt. I was really pushing down the hill, and I think you were behind me.
Yeah.
And out of nowhere, it just snapped.
Bro.
Like, literally. I hit a bump, and that bitch just snapped right under me. And I was running down the hill, like, with the ball in front of me, to like, trying not to fucking faceplant. And the deck's just like sliding down, but we were going on a steep ass hill. That was the most random shit. And then I had to walk all the way back to House Park, get a fucking spare deck that luckily somebody had there, or that I brought, put it on. I think it was I don't even remember. You know how it'd be at the gym. You know how it'd be at the gym.
God. I like faintly remember that. We were all riding the hill bomb spot.
Yeah, I missed that spot. I think I put I put my Phoenix back on. I want to say I had a Phoenix Ion. I rode that bitch for literally so long. Like the six had come out. I was at the Chicago gym. I fucking was the only motherfucker there with like how wide was the Phoenix Dex? Like the old ones. I had the
maybe five.
I
don't even think they were 5'5", dude. Like they were tiny.
Tyler Bradley was.
I had the Tyler Bradley one. On a five. Yeah, I had the Tyler Bradley one. Tyler J. Bradley.
Double kings on a five.
For real. I was riding that bitch for a minute. King drill too, that bitch is actually like. Got the Phoenix had the strongest decks because that thing was like. They put that bitch through hell.
Man, put RIP. Rip Phoenix.
Phoenix decks literally never snapped though.
Y'all remember that shit? In my garage.
Yeah.
The Reventon was a tank. I've seen literally. Like a couple like meme photos of like a snapped Reventon.
Really?
And they're like, shit, like.
They had to fake that shit. Yeah. I don't know. They had to cut that shit or something, bro. Fuck. Because them bitches are literally unsnappable. I don't know.
They were fire. It was like very rare.
Yeah. The one I had.
Phoenix.
The Iron, I still got that bitch. Still
shout out up. Tyler Bonner.
Tyler Bradley or Tyler Bonner? Which one?
Tyler Bonner.
Tyler Bonner. Tyler Boner. Shout out Tyler Boner.
Oh, God. Stay up.
Stay up, get your cake up. And wake up, because we trying to play up. Don't make up.
Freestyle if you want.
Preach.
Freestyle.
You got one in
freestyle.
You?
Freestyle.
Yeah, man, you got we can throw on a beat right now. If you don't need a
beat,
though.
I don't need a beat.
Okay.
Just goes.
I just go in, because Austin, my twin, we on the do-rags, because I'm in. I'm on. I'm strong. I'm coming on hard, like I'm on the phone with your girl. She trying to pipe. I rode my bike to a house, and then I went in it all night. I'm done. What's the next question? I think I'm like, what the fuck? This dude's on something.
God.
I can hit that, though? On the camera? Yeah. Let's get it.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. We could vape.
Beautiful.
For sure. I'm addicted, so I'm a definitely have to be vaping on this thing.
Just like to say, Josh Fuller, I'm not going to hit this vape for a year, and I'm going to make you quit.
Oh, yeah.
I'm a month
in. He was telling me about that earlier, Josh.
This guy's down me. I know that
this is going to be the funniest thing when it happens. It's all love. Because neither of them actually know what's actually going to happen.
I said, Josh is going to stun you out, bro. Josh is
the only one who does.
It's going to be exactly like how he was last night. Funny. Yeah, I'm going to come out with you guys.
You can never, have your cake and eat it, too. Just know that.
Thanks. Two out of three. And
it's just
because
I love
him
that I'm going to fulfill this promise.
Right. So now you have
I can't wait.
Well, bro. I shook hands. I'm going to keep my word. You're gonna
I know
quit.
You are, and so is Josh.
Josh, you're going
like
to keep your
you
word?
You got to read the fine print.
Yeah? You don't keep your word? And quit? Or you don't know? Do be deciding. Do be deciding. Yeah,
I can do it.
I believe in Paxton. Paxton is a literal fucking OG of Florida. Not OG, but I mean, I don't want to like talk bad.
I appreciate that. Bad. Nah, dude. Okay, if we're being real, OGs of Florida, fucking Florida ride, bro.
Florida
like,
ride is yeah.
We got Mike Holman, fucking
Mike, Brian
Duff Beer,
Olivia
Brian,
Duff.
Yeah, like those are the OGs.
Joe Calzone.
I fucking wish I grew up where they did, man. But for I'm real. In North Florida. Like, I'm in that inbred town.
Shout out
no
Hector.
Scooter
shout out my boy Hector, bro. Hector is the real OG of Florida scootering. Hector is a fucking...
I
went to Florida.
Shout out what the heck.
Shout out Wombat. Literally, Wombat is a fucking pimp. Wombat.
For real.
I love Wombat so much.
For real, bro.
In a game, Emmanuel.
That motherfucker's a lumberjack.
For real, dude. Wombat is the coolest dude. Like, whenever I went to his house, it was like... They had a good vibe the whole time I was there. We got like buku clips out there, and they had a. We went to this ditch spot that was sick as fuck. It was like downtown Tampa. Tampa's cool as fuck. That's the only place in Florida I've been. But
that's a lie. You've been to Destin.
Destin. I mean, like in like toward. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I got it. It's like south. Yeah, that's fucking. It's totally different. South Florida's way different from the Panhandle.
Yeah. Well. Yeah. I've been to Destin, fucking Pensacola, Fort Walton, Panama.
Yeah.
All down that coast. Paxton lives on a fucking crazy ass part of the United States. if you haven't visited that part of the United States.
Top five places to retire in Florida.
Yeah.
Niceville, Florida.
It's so, dude, I love going there. I would live there. But, I mean, there's not a lot of scootering there.
That's true. That's the one reason. That's why I moved out here. I wanted to come to Austin to just get to ride more, be with the homies. But that'll always be home. Like, that's definitely the place to go retire. That shit's...
And you're local. Or, like, the park that I went and met you at. What was that park called?
Niceville Center of Youth. The fucking local. Dude, that was my... It's my birthing grounds for scootering, and it's fucked, man. A park ran by people that don't ride, don't do their own shit or nothing, so they don't know what the fuck to do with the city's money, and fucked it up, man.
Dude, that park was low-key, like...
That's the same
thing. It was a sesh, but, like, there wasn't much there.
Yeah, it's like one of those prefab parks where it's, like, people... They just kind of put ramps on the ground, but...
And they had a bowl, though. They had a big-ass bowl. That bowl, or the pool...
You're thinking about Fort Walton, the concrete park, but that park's sick. Yeah. Team Payne actually built that bowl, and that shit's sick. But my local's the Niceville Center of Youth.
Oh, nice, it's like that's the one I'm. Yeah, Niceville Center has a lot of shit there. Yeah, I'm talking about the one that was in Fort Walton. It didn't have too much right there. I mean, they had a good bit, but
fucking that Fort Walton park is sick, bro. Dude, Team Payne killed it on that bowl. That's the only bowl around me, so that's clutch. Got a shout out to that, but. Niceville will always be the local. Something about like a wooden prefab is just perfect, bro. So much fun. That's home to me. I know you grew up on concrete parks, though.
Yeah, I grew up on concrete park.
Yeah, I feel like you built a little tougher if you grew up on a concrete park.
It just happened, bro.
I've never really rode wood parks.
I mean, the only like dope ass wood park that I've rode was in Dallas. Which one it is?
Lewis?
No.
Alliance.
Alliance. Oh, yeah. Check them out.
So hard.
The man.
We talked about this in the other episode. Zibai. I have no idea which one will come out first, but it's Caleb's bar twist into Sunset. He did this twice to get the photo. So,
yeah. Let's just remind y'all of that.
Buku Wild.
Buku.
Man's a G.
That boy.
Wildin.
That boy crazy, man.
That boy Kuyan. You don't know what Kuyan means. It's a Cajun word for crazy.
That boy, Kuyan.
Straight up. That boy, Duffy. Kuyan. Y'all ever heard Duffy?
My boy, Duffy, yeah.
That boy, Duffy. Yeah.
My boy, Duffy.
Duffy.
Shout out my boy, Duffy. Shout out my boy, T-Doll. Shout out all the pimps in the building.
Yeah, I grew up on concrete parks, too, though. Like, my local is Breck Skate Park. Shout out Breck Skate Park. Shout out all the OGs there. Shout out Michael Wyman.
Is sick.
Shout out Brushy Creek.
Brushy Creek is a fuck. Like, that's still my favorite skate park around here. I don't know. I like it, but, like, because, I mean.
It's so fun.
That's our favorite.
It is fun.
That's the best slash, for sure.
I would be down to go to fucking Brushy tomorrow if I stayed longer. But we
should have gone tonight.
Wish. For real.
We should have gone tonight, bro.
I forget about it.
But, I mean, I really do like Wells, so too. Wells is a lot of fun.
We had a good sesh at Wells, man.
Yeah.
That was fun.
You got active.
I
wish I could have got a better clip and to get that gap to rail.
Bro, that gap to rail was hard as fuck and you had to crack out. Like, that shit was
I had to crack out when I did it.
Swamp ass hanging out.
I had the swamp ass for real.
We're gonna the clip's gonna be playing over this. But yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Get a real
pose that shit.
Crack. Piece of this.
Straight up swamp had that daddy. Swamp ass in that bitch for real. I gotta post that on my gram. For real, I gotta post that on my gram.
Got you. God.
Shorty gonna be hyping you up in that one.
Yeah, she gonna be, dang, you got cake.
Like, my man thick.
Just follow me on Instagram. Follow me on Instagram. Swamp Daddy with two Y's.
Two. Amen. How do you spell it? Because I feel like I always type in the swamp wrong.
Well, I used to spell it S-C-H-W-A-M-P, Daddy, but then I changed it to just the regular way to spell swamp, S-W-A-M-P.
Okay.
Cool. D-A-D-D, but two cool. Y's, because the motherfucker that has one Y is some, like, OG from, like, fucking 2009 when Instagram first came out. And, like, he still has, like, a picture of, like, you know, them old-ass Instagram old filters? Yeah. Them weird-ass ones. They're, like, Fuji or something, Fiji.
Fiji
photos on, like, all of his shit. Instagram's gotten crazy, though. Let's just talk about that for a second. Like, I've been on Instagram, posting on Instagram for, like...
Before you could even put videos on that bitch.
I got like 246 on there. I've been posting on that shit for so long, but like, it's just weird how like.
I legit made like an Instagram post around Christmas at one point, and I was like, all I want for Christmas is longer than 15 second videos on Instagram.
Fact.
Like, I used to be like chopping. Yeah. If I got multiple clips, I'm making them like 1-2 seconds each. Like,
for real.
It was so tough. It's
the struggle. Insta's come a long way.
Yeah.
Put it back in chronological order. You
see, my first Instagram post.
Yes.
Those were the days.
Bullshit.
Yeah, my first algorithm. Fucking...
I don't want to see these fools post from 3 days ago. I already missed it. I don't give a fuck anymore.
I posted on Instagram for the first time like 2014.
Yeah.
I think, yeah. Had the razor, El Dorado.
Yeah, respect. I don't be archiving any of my shit either. If people want to dig deep and see when I was a little scrub, go for it.
Yeah,
it's like, I respect that. Keeping it all up.
Oh, I got that archived.
Got the bat. Okay.
I had like too many of just random shit on my Instagram because I would post like a lot of dumb shit.
Oh, for sure. Yeah.
Then like,
for sure.
I was like, fuck. I got like older. I was like, I put some weird shit in this video. I might as well.
I definitely threw some iFunny memes.
But
up
this
there.
Is like 2015. Yeah. Oh, I think this is the earliest one I have. But yeah, bro. Back when like people use this shit on their Instagram things. I remember that. Like the fucking.
The black borders.
Yeah, they would use like pic collage or like.
You couldn't do horizontal.
Yeah.
On the frame.
Dude.
Yeah, fuck. Dude.
Struggles, bro.
I remember it was 15, then we got to 30. Reels. Now we have 1 minute. Like, you guys are crazy. You know? You remember that? It was like 15, it went to 30 seconds, and then now it's a minute. And then now you can post, like, YouTube videos on that bitch, basically.
IGTV is crazy.
Yeah.
Fucking, what'd you think about, how do you feel about Instagram scootering?
Everybody on there is crazy.
For real, bro. It's like I get on the app, and I get a little unmotivated by how good these motherfuckers are.
And then I'll be like hashtagging.
Yeah.
I'd be like, damn, they ain't post me on here. I kind of be like, you know, but it don't matter.
Yeah.
You know?
It don't.
I'd be hashtagging Olay. I'll never be on that bitch. I ain't really tripping though. It's more for little kids. I understand that. I'm like 21 years old.
I'm sponsored by them and they don't even really post me that much. But like,
yeah.
It doesn't really, like, none of that shit really matters.
No, not really.
Not at all.
But.
You post the YouTube videos.
Scooter That's Cloud's really cool, matters. But
yeah,
really ain't shit.
It's weird. It's weird.
Really ain't shit. Yeah,
to really like, ain't shit.
Garage.
Motherfuckers just be like getting crazy fucking good, like, and then just blow up. Like, fuck. Who am I thinking about?
OD,
exactly. Yeah. That's like the perfect example. I remember I followed OD for like the longest time, and like ever since he like a kid, and I like. Me and Dakota would watch him, like, way back in the day. And I was like, that kid's going to be a fucking goat. Like, me and him was just calling that shit.
Bro, I met him at Woodward when I was 19, and I think he was 14.
Yeah, I've never even talked to him before, so, like, it's kind of weird to talk about him. But
Yeah. But, nah, cool. Man's cool.
Yeah.
Fucking just, like, riding with them and the Boston dudes.
Yeah, I like DM'd
him. It was like,
I ain't never talked to him.
Homie, you're... probably just as good as me, maybe a little bit better. This is in like 2019, and you're 14. And
right.
It's like from there, he's on a whole nother level now.
Man, whip from, can we talk about that? Whip from 50 to Hollywood 16? Scootering. What the fuck?
For real, bro. Kicks his head tube too.
He kicked his head tube?
Yeah, he kicked his fucking head tube and then put his foot back on mid trick.
That shit was literally like, stupid.
Yeah.
I didn't even see that shit, but like when I watched that shit, my mouth dropped. Like I watched that shit like 10 times.
Bro,
I was like, what the fuck?
Riding with him and Gabe in person is fucking humbling. You're damn, I kind of suck at riding a scooter if I put this shit into perspective.
I bet,
but it's even better. It's like you feed off that shit.
Yeah.
It's so dope being around some dudes like that. You ride better. They push you.
Right.
I could probably double whip from 50 that bitch. I'm not gonna lie.
Easy, bro. Man's got the whip. My son front. Got the full heel to front 50.
Yeah, bro.
Oh God, I could probably bust that one out.
Full heel to front lip. Full heel to
back out
lip,
there,
bro. Bro, we need to go. Let's make a Cali trip straight up. I'm down to go to Cali. I'm down to copy Airbnb. What you say?
I'm trying to get Cali full burrito. Front. God,
bullshitting.
Cali burrito.
Nice Cali burrito.
Ooh, get some French fries now.
That's what
Yeah.
You been to Cali too? You been like riding around in Cali or just A-Town?
A-Town. Just A-Town. And then, Yeah, I'm pretty sure just A-Town. I was in L.A. for like 3 hours when we first got there, waiting for Landon to get there because he had the whip to take us to, where is it, Slow?
Atascadero.
Atascadero.
Atascadero. So, how do you even spell that shit? Y'all got some crazy-ass names out there in California.
I don't even know. But, fucking went to Westchester, slipperiest park on earth. That shit was hard to ride.
I like Westchester. I've been out there. I went out to Cali when I was like 15.
It's a sick fun, park. But
shout
it's
out, slippery. Shout out Jesus.
Every time I go there.
Yeah.
Shout out Jesus. He a pimp.
You know Jesus Valgrass?
Yeah.
I think that's how you say A-B-A-G-R, grass, something like that.
Yeah. He's a pimp.
I'm kind of eager.
Caleb introduced me to him.
Dude, he's a pimp. He's cool tight. As fuck. That's like the only guy out. I worked at. Bro. Dude, Arthur is like an OG at that bitch. I'm sorry. I don't watch the custom builds no more, but like when I was a kid, I'd always watch Arthur's.
Yeah.
And like, that man, you know who I'm talking about? Arthur,
yeah,
like,
Senia.
He don't ride no more, does he?
I don't think so.
I don't think he does, but he was like the OG vault worker.
Yeah.
Like, I'm sorry, Walter, but you'll never be as cool as Arthur.
That's respectable. You can't beat the OG.
Gotta be honest.
Yeah, it's the end of the day.
Outside had some pretty sick ones. Didn't they have some custom builds?
Yeah.
Pretty sure they did. Outside had like a custom build or two. I think probably I might be couple. Tripping.
They probably I'm not sure. But let's fucking, bro, Outside's closing.
Yeah.
That's crazy. I think they ran things the best.
Austin, what's your opinion on Outside closing?
Be honest.
I didn't know he had something to say.
I mean, bro, like, a lot of their riders, shout out Reese Duizma. Like, that's the pimp.
Fucking
like,
goat.
Besides that, shout out Legaush. That's the pimp. Besides that, I didn't really fuck with them. Their merch is cool. I'll be rocking their merch.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I don't know. It sucks, bro. I'd be shopping at the farm or the vault.
Yeah, so I know like, you're a scooter tripping. Farm guy. You take farm over Outset, right?
Yeah, 100%. Yeah.
For me, I feel Outset does have cooler merch. Aesthetic, though.
They have cooler merch. Yeah. They had a solid aesthetic. For but, sure. like, it's just, like, the people on. Like, I prefer, like, the farm or, like, the vault. I'd rather kind of, like, support Word. Them as my shop of choice. But Word. Sucks to see them go.
Real man. Yeah. I feel like I'm definitely an Outset boy. Like, what their videos... And
they did have really
know.
Good
I feel
videos.
Like they had a pretty heavy influence on me because, like, the first jam I ever went to was the Chicago jam.
Yeah, I remember.
And, like, that, yeah, bro. Like,
I think I was there with you at that jam, and then we met up, and I was, all right, so I hit that kid on the rail, and then I was fucked up. Literally, okay.
We'll throw that in
there. Let me tell y'all this story of Chicago because it was the most craziest, like, street jam I've been to.
Bro, I watched you get your shit rocked multiple times.
I did try to do this double heel rail hop over the Grant rail, and I literally said to Mark Williams,
it's
I was like,
be up.
I was like, I said, look, told Mark, I was like, you want to see me eat shit? He was like, no, bro, I don't want to see you eat shit. Don't eat
shout
shit.
Out Mark Williams.
For real, we went to Taco Bell with that man, me and Paxton at like 2 or 3 in the morning, and yeah. we get there, and Mark is like, yo, y'all still open? She's like, no. Oh, he's like, please. He was like, we just pushed like 5 miles. All I need is a taco. She's like, I'm sorry, baby. I can't help you. And he was like, come on, man. It'll take like 5 minutes. And she's like, no, I'm sorry. You're just going to have to go down the street to somewhere else. He's like, fuck.
All right.
Yeah. He's like, all right. We left. Me and Paxton went.
Tell them off in Japanese. But yeah. That's crazy. I fucking, I remember we saw the Y2K premiere.
Yeah.
You remember that shit?
Yeah, that shit was crazy too.
Faded. We were riding those like little rails in the parking cross.
Dude,
the parking
and I was
lot
fucked
across
up.
Across the street.
I was like literally could barely walk because like I'd hit my face. And then at the other spot where like Kirk did that wall run like thing, I tried to finger whip that. I fucking landed like this with my feet hanging back and then just like cheese grated in my fucking leg. Oh. So like all my legs were cut up fucking. I had a big ass cut on my face right here, and I had a black eye and a blood vessel popped in my eye. And then when we went to the fucking other spot and I was going down, the other kid was going up. I was going up and he was going down because everybody was riding up. But shout out to Canyon Devil because that shit was crazy. But I was kind of looking down because like I got a bad habit of just looking down when I ride. I'm like, damn, yeah. My feet look cool as fuck.
Bro, I feel that.
I'm sick.
I get a little oblivious when I scooter.
Yeah, I don't like that in person though. And I feel like I need to just look up more in general.
Yeah, yeah. Mike, looking down. Shout out Mike Dijon. He DM'd me the other day. When I posted a video of me eating shit, he was like, you need to look up. And ever since then, I've been looking up and it's been working out.
Hell yeah.
But yeah, I ate shit doing
he's
that.
He's a stepfather now. He's like got that fatherly advice to give.
Exactly. I'm like, damn,
he's
bro.
Looking out for us.
I never even realized that. Thank you. Please give me some more tips if you have some, man. But Austin will still probably crush the game of Scoot, but we'll talk about that.
I always beat him, but he's still one of my favorite people to play.
Yeah.
Just because, like, he has a good, like, big bag of tricks.
Yeah, he does.
Like, he'll do one trick. Like, he'll do 50 backflip whip, and then he'll do 50 backflip heel, and then he'll do 50 backflip bar, and it's just, like, we're just going back and forth. Like.
Yeah, session that bitch.
He was the first ever Texan scooter rider I met. Ever.
Really?
Yeah, I came to Dallas with some
Steve,
family.
Well, he's not even a Texan scooter rider.
He's
like
not
the East Coast.
Damn, that was the first dude I made.
He's not born and bred. But
he's not
Texas
born and bred. I never knew that. But
moved
I did used
to
watch
Texas,
Mike.
And he told everybody that his name was Steve for like 2 weeks.
That's what awesome. The fuck?
Like dead
what's
ass.
Right?
Dead ass.
Yeah,
Steve
I ate
here.
Shit
call
doing
Mike
that
Young Steve if you ever see him. See what he says.
I'm gonna do that next time. I just usually call him Dad because me and him have always been a, like ever since the
I
first
always
gym,
have seen that.
I was like, bro, like. I mean, I'm not going to lie. You kind of look like my older brother. Like, you know what I'm saying? Or my dad. And, like, he understood that. He was like, yeah, for real. Like, we took a selfie on Instagram when he was at Parasite. Literally looked like he was like.
He's like, I am your father.
Look like I came out of his nutsack. No homo. Like, on some weird shit. But literally looked like the man's kid when I was younger. I don't think we resemble each other too much anymore, but. Back in the day. Yeah.
Yeah. I've heard some like crackhead activities going down at Parasite.
Yeah,
you got any Parasite stories from that skate park?
Worst thing I could say is my friend got his bag stolen there. Another thing is, they had like 4 or 5 people get killed there a few years back or
damn,
probably more than that. New Orleans is fucking crazy. It's always sketchy as fuck going to Parasite. I was there at like 11 o'clock at night the other night and I did not feel safe. I don't know why. Nobody's there. I had like my homies. Shout out Gant, Aiden Gant on Instagram.
Shout out Gant.
We seen him.
But yeah, it is weird at night. They had some bitch get beat up there the other night.
Jesus. Yeah, I've heard some
literally
stories.
Like, dragged around by her hair and shit.
By a dude or a girl?
No, it's two girls, I'm pretty sure. I don't know what was it about.
Tight.
There's a lot of
little
fights.
Cat fight.
At my local, there's a lot of fist fights. Brick at Parasite. I'm pretty sure, yeah, there's a lot.
People are too soft here. I wish they fought at skate park.
Yeah, but it's funny as fuck. Like, literally. It'll be like, we'll be like just chilling, and then like some will pop off, and then somebody will just get beat the shit out of. Like, shout out Coleman Reed. That man literally fucking body slammed some guy at like a skate jam. He's like a skater by me. And I was like fucking like 15 years old. I see him fucking boom, slam this dude, like knock him the fuck out. I was like, damn, dude. I want to be like you when I grow up.
We literally just get like a bunch of hipster douchebags pulling up with like a full drum set and like guitars and mics and shit, like playing music like in front of the Six Stair at house. I'm like, bro,
closing
fuck y'all.
Time.
Yeah, they've been doing that at my skate park. It's weird.
I'm like, they're lucky I'm not there, bro. But that's why I don't go to house. Like, it's just bullshit.
Yeah.
It's packed. Park is
old
so
heads
packed.
Trying to kickflip. Maybe do a little backtail.
A lot of sneak dissers.
A lot of
people
sneak
thinking you're getting
you
in
do
a
backflip and they're
full
like,
park.
Oh, bro, dude. Like, that was actually sick as fuck.
Yeah, really, like, dude, you're insane.
I don't really fuck with scooter riders like
I don't really
that,
fuck with scooter riders, yeah.
The coolest
you're
kind
of cool. Just don't snake me, though.
Yeah.
I love that backhanded compliment.
Like, all right, fuck you.
Thanks, bro.
I don't give a fuck if you think I'm cool.
If a skater says that to me, I see if he's pulling up with a girl, bro.
Mm-hmm. I'm like, bro, you're just mad because your girl
like
is fucking digging these scooters.
She just seen that and said how cool it was to you. And now you're going to come over here and tell me about it.
Uh-huh.
Literally.
I impress your girl.
I feel like most of the dudes who talk shit, though, can barely kickflip. It's like.
Yeah.
Sometimes that's how it
They're
is.
They're projecting their hatred.
Yeah, 100%.
Just commit, young love, boys though, and girls. You can do it. You can kickflip.
If I committed, I would have never ate shit on that rail hop. I didn't do shit after that. I remember Paxton back to the Chicago gym. Like, yeah. I left Paxton there. I didn't go to sleep that night. I got back to my fucking I got to the airport.
Yeah.
And they delayed my flight. And I was stuck at I got to Dallas. I flew out and I had a connecting flight in Dallas. And I was stuck in Dallas for 18 hours on the way back from after eating shit. I had like cuts all over me and shit. That was like a shitty ass time. I never wanted to go to another street jam.
Bro. I'm definitely going to
shower.
I need you to send me those clips.
Yeah.
I'll throw them up, but I just can't believe you ate shit like that twice. It's like, that's like two viral clips, especially the one where you bodied that motherfucker. It is a viral clip.
Go viral, yeah.
I know it's been on SportsCenter.
Dude, I still see that shit. People still send me that on Snapchat, and it's crazy because like I didn't get tagged in it. That shit low key is bumming, but like. You know, I still know it's me. Like, I still, laugh my fucking ass off every time I see that bitch.
Decked, homie. Like, if we're being honest here, it's
I grab him. If you slow-mo it,
yeah.
I look up, and I'm like, damn, what the fuck is he doing? Why is he still going?
It looks your shoulder connects, like, right on his chin.
Yeah.
You're like, you gave that boy CTE.
I was good.
Bro. You were unscathed, bro. You're like, I'm a tank.
I remember somebody said,
my boy.
I remember
you
somebody.
Right, Niff?
I was like, you good, me dog? I was like, shit, my bad. somebody thought I was finna beat his ass.
I
fucking pushed myself up. I was like, holy shit. Because Jesus had like smoked a joint with me, like right after I'd face planted. And
what you need.
Yeah, I was like, fuck, I'm good to ride again. So I got back up. That happened. I'm like, I ate shit on that finger whip. Then that happened. And then I was like, okay, I'm just going to go get drunk.
That's street jams, bro. Unless someone sends me out there, like, paying for my shit, like, I usually just go out there and get faded and chill. Honestly, if someone's paying for me, I feel obligated to do some tricks.
I
still do some tricks faded. Like, I'm not going to lie. I'll hit, like, at least one at some spots.
Awesome. If I'm killing it at the Denver gym.
We take calculated
Denver
risks.
Denver was fun.
If you're feeling it, we take calculated risks.
I'm not going to do some dumb shit because everybody's there. But like,
I know my Johnsons. I know what I got.
I'll scoop this real quick.
Yeah. Okay.
Literally, my man's was hitting the fuck. What'd you hit on the 10 stair where I broke my hand at the Denver gym?
We got to put that clip up, too.
I did, like, a few trick, like, 184 whip. Definitely did triple heel.
Full whip.
Shout out Oliver Steele,
you didn't
my little
catch
sister.
It.
My little sister
I never
was
catch
fucking it up at the gym.
Whips, bro. They're literally always on the ground.
Yeah. Your what? Your full whip?
Anytime I do full a full whip. Whip. Like, the one I did in me and Caleb's split part.
Come a little closer.
It was literally just first try.
Really?
And, like.
Damn.
Yeah, I just did it, and I was like, I'm definitely not doing that one again. But every other one, even though I'm trying, like, a few times, it's like, it just always happens like that. And they're kind of ugly, but that's why I just try and do it down something, like, kind of fat.
Like a fucking roof with, like, a tennis court, and
bro, you got
instead of doing full whip, he does 180.
What's that?
That was
for real,
bro.
That's honestly one of my favorite clips in scootering.
So
not even, like... You killed that shit, and the fact that it took you three separate attempts
to actually get it two separate times.
Yeah, bro.
Threw well.
Losing it, but it's like,
type,
I mean, if we're being
shit.
Honest here,
type
those
shit.
First two were filmed
hard.
Like a dog shit, so it was totally
it was
necessary fit. For you to redo.
Shout out my boy Connor for deleting the fucking clip.
Connor deleted?
Yeah, Pac Metro.
He deleted like three of
doing?
Them. I had to redo a few clips, but...
Damn,
yeah.
Connor.
My boy, I wish he was here tonight.
Damn,
he was here last night. He
Connor, shout out.
We got
super grim
like
last night with Pack.
Oh, God. Shout out Pack. He was wingmaning. All the boys had a good time with some shorties last night. That's all I'm going to say.
Millers right now.
It was like 4 for 4, essentially.
We love you.
Yeah. It was a good time. That's honestly one of the first times I went out and like all the boys were like on their shit.
It's my second time ever on sixth, but
time.
I didn't even get to experience it the first time. Like, you gave me my first true sixth experience.
You went to Dirty Six, and we got dirty, because that's just how it works, bro. Shout out Connor again. His fucking sugar mama or some shit sent him $100, so he just started buying, like, drinks for us, like, off the bat. Y'all already saw it. We were getting twisted on here. Yeah. Like, I don't remember most of it, but I was up to like 5 or 6 a.m.
Bro, that was a good night.
Yeah, we'll run it back. Say,
if y'all come out here, like,
we'll run it back.
We'll introduce you to the dirty.
Bring some money, though, because that shit's taxed.
Yeah, it is. I spent a lot.
Taxed. It's like $60 for 4 shots for the boy. Like, probably maybe less, but
about definitely taxed.
$7-$8 a shot.
Downtown Austin, it's like Austin is sick. Like, fuck,
it's tight.
6th Street is sick, but like, there's so many other spots. Like, I mean, I don't really know the names of them, but like, Barton is like the coolest fucking river ever. Like, I like it more than the river by my house, because like, I'm not scared. I'm gonna get fucking eaten by a gator. Like, I'll be like water skiing by me, and like in the swamp, like with like in Man Shack, where it's like the most infested part, like with alligators and shit. Well, I say that, I don't know, but like. Literally, they be having buku foot. Like, I've literally been on a jet ski and have been next to an alligator, like, looking at it. My mom's like, don't get off, don't get off. She points at it. Literally, an alligator right there. And I'm on the water skis. I'm like, I said jet skis. I'm on the water skis. I'm like, oh, fuck. There's like mobbing. We'll like ride all the way to Lake Pontchartrain because my brother lives on the Tickfall River, which is like basically like swamp people really did a lot of fucking shit over there. I forgot who did it, but they did like a whole like area, because they had like different areas like Monroe, Tickfall, and like Lake Pontchartrain. Because like, to get to New Orleans, you go over Lake Pontchartrain.
Gonna hop on for a sec, Josh.
No, nope. Real quick,
I'm
just
about to go pee,
like,
bro. 2 minutes.
Yeah, go for it, brother. Get your
piss
out.
I just wanted to get Josh in here for a sec.
Come on, Josh, you hopping in?
I know you want to get on here with my nephew.
Why not?
He's off that gorilla finger right now. Them boys were getting goobed up this whole time we've been
Justin
talking,
ain't
bro.
Even
I've been
alive,
getting jealous
bro.
Walking over there. Justin. Justin's fit as like fuck this right over there. Oh, my God. Them boys.
Pass over the Puffco.
Can we hit the Puffco on here, do you think?
Fuck it. I feel like... Fuck it. I mean, I think we can.
It's a big vape.
Yeah, it is. It's healthy. We're being healthy.
Yeah, bro. My body's literally fucked from today. I need some CBD.
Well, I want to get into like what you be doing, like your hustle, because you be mowing lawns.
Oh yeah,
and like you go hard.
Self-made millionaire.
You're out here. You're actually out here mowing.
I be cutting.
Bitch.
Like, I got a trailer from a brother-in-law. He, like, just gave it to me because we used to cut, like, 60 yards. And then we got up to, like, 80 yards even. And then, like, we had a big flood over where I live in Louisiana. And we stopped cutting as many. And then he started working a different place. So I got a lawn trailer with the lawn business. Ever since then, I kind of, like, stopped cutting, like, the shit that I would, like, not make a lot of money with. Like, there'd be amount of yards, like, say, like, $40. And I'm like, I'm not trying to cut small-ass yards. I'd rather just cut big yards. So I'd be cutting, like, 4 or 5 acre yards. I have like 15 residential yards, and I got like 3 commercial yards that are just at this place called Best Stop.
Hell yeah.
I'll be doing that.
Are you even working for a company, or like you just doing that shit on your own?
I work for LaFleur's Plumbing.
LaFleur's
Plumbing. Shout out LaFleur's Plumbing.
Damn, bro.
Shout out all my homies.
Yeah, I just know you're out here, bro. Oh, you're hustling. You took it. I feel like that's what most parents tell you. They're like, oh, you want some shit? Go mow the lawn.
Yeah.
And
for real, bro. That's basically how it is. I've paid for every trip that I've been on out of my own pocket. No sponsor has ever, like, sponsored me. Like, I mean, brother. Shout out, brother. Yeah, that's the only sponsor I've ever had. I was sponsored on Cryptic Pro Scooters when I was, like, 13.
Yeah, I remember that.
But, like.
Nah, fuck them.
Huh?
How much did they really help you?
Cryptic didn't do really shit, honestly. Yeah. Not to hate, but Cryptic didn't do nothing. Brother, of course, brother is a plug. Always love.
Oh yeah,
brother scooters.
Shout out Matt Ogle. We love you.
Matt is like the coolest fucking guy.
For real, bro. That's like the mentor of Texas scootering, right there.
For real, bro. Yeah. Literally, he's the goat.
Literally,
y'all definitely gonna have him on here.
We'll definitely get Matthew on here. I know
Matt's is gonna be like 3 hours long because that dude has so much interesting shit to say.
He's got knowledge. Like, you ever just like be talking to him and he starts spitting some wisdom on you?
Yeah.
Like, he's definitely, I could see him as a mentor.
Yeah, OG.
Yeah. Even though I know Austin, fuck, that man damn near raised Austin in the scene.
Yeah. That's what Austin told me.
Yeah.
But yeah, man. Work at the Floors Plumbing.
Yeah.
And that's and I'd be riding whenever I get off. So I'll probably work like 40 hours a week. But add some to that because I'll be cutting a lot of grass whenever it's summertime.
Yeah.
But like, I'm trying to go on more trips this year.
Fuck yeah.
I know you guys are too.
Definitely. I just want to go to as many jams as we can go to this summer. I've like worked at Woodward the past 3 years, so I haven't really been to a bunch of jams the past 3 years since I've been working there, and fuck, I want to do
that. You ain't working at Woodward this year?
I would love to go for like 2 weeks, but not 6 weeks. I definitely don't think I'm going to go for as long as I've been going.
Yeah, I can fuck with that.
Yeah. 2 weeks would be nice.
2 weeks would be fun, but I lose my like job and shit.
Yeah, yeah. If we could get into Buds too, that'd be real luxury.
Get into what?
And that get the Guest Pro Barn.
Yeah, that'd be crazy.
Yeah, dude,
that'd be sick.
That place is sick.
If you ever get in the Guest Pro Barn, let me come. I'll fucking swamp that bitch up.
You know we're stacking if we get out there. Have you ever been to Woodward?
No, I've never been to Woodward.
Bro, we're gonna get your ass to PA. That place is magical. Yeah. It's so fun.
I really want to go to Woodward. Yeah. I've always wanted to go to the Woodward since I was like.
I've never been to the one in Cali. I'm trying to go there too.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't even know they had one in Cali. Shit.
Yeah. West.
Oh, the one in Pennsylvania. That's where it is. That's the one you worked at.
Yeah, yeah. That's where I worked. It's the oldest one. Fucking bro. By the way, because I feel like we did the same shit. It's like we rode by ourselves for a good portion of our just like I guess us growing up. I feel like most of my friends quit Scooter and like. 2015, 2016. I was just like riding by myself. What kept you going? What made you?
What kept me going is coming out here.
Yeah,
it's coming out to Austin.
Yeah, yeah.
And going to different places.
Fuck yeah.
And another thing is like I seen how hard Dakota. I seen how hard Dakota used to go, and then that man quit when he got on tilt. And I was like, ever since then, like me and Dakota had always had like a homie. Thing.
Yeah,
and like we would just like push each other.
Yeah,
so like I guess just learning from him, like kept pushing myself and shit.
Wow,
and it just like I don't really care. I do it. Yeah, shout out Justin.
Yeah,
but I just be doing it for fun at this point.
Yeah, I feel like for me it's like shit keeps me happy at the end of the day. It's like if I'm not doing it at all, I'm just kind of bummed. Like I need it in my life, and I don't know. I can relate to that. It's weird just. It's a mind game, solo bro. All the time. Yeah.
It's like a real life video game. Yeah. Real shit.
And especially, I feel like we talked about, it's like you won't be filming. You're not with any of your homies. Mm-hmm. Like, we're doing shit. People will think, like, you're not out here riding. It's like, nah, I'm active. Like, this is a part of me. I'm scootering.
I won't even be filming. Like, I ride like every day and I don't barely get any clips. It's like, I post an Instagram clip maybe like once a month. Maybe.
That's what it's about.
Maybe if I'm like, maybe if I'm like fucking really mobbing and got somebody to film, I'll be like two. Maybe like three Instagram clips, but
because people take that shit too easily, and it's just take that shit too seriously, and that'll take the fun out of it.
Shit's whack.
Yeah.
If it's more than 10 tries for an Insta clip, bro, I stop.
It's like give it 15. I mean, max I'm not that way.
I'm not gonna lie. I'd be fucking wanting to get Instagram clips when I can, because like if it's a certain person filming me and that's like a trick I really want, then like I'm gonna do like my hardest to get to that because. I don't have a lot of people to film me.
Yeah. Especially if you're in a new spot. Like, like being out here, like you're not gonna be back here.
Like I was pissed off today I didn't get some of the clips I got like at house. But like I mean then I'm like I could do it at my local.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I was so fucked. Like, bro, I seen you get snaked at least 20 times.
Bro. I actually got clips across
the park.
There's one, I'll throw it up right now if you're watching the video, but homie did a board slide. Yeah, you did a board slide up that rail, and some fool had headphones on going up the ramp, and your deck was up. Millimeter away from this motherfucker.
Yeah,
bro. Oh, the dude with the headphones, is that what you said? Yeah, he pulled it out. He's like, I couldn't hear that shit. He's like, oh my God. Like,
you almost snaked him too. I was so pissed
Fuck them all, bro. They were pissing me off too.
I would have landed. I feel like I would have landed that.
Yeah, I did almost snake Joe. I did.
Yeah, but it didn't. I said I feel like I could have landed that if like I was consistently.
If you would have heel whipped that attempt, you would have fucking hit him right in his chest. You would have
taken his teeth.
You would have heard that shit.
I would have Dakota.
He's got dental insurance.
Yeah, that was funny as fuck.
But I literally put my hand out to like, I was like one handed board sliding. I thought I was gonna hit him. I like kind of put my hand off my deck. I still landed the up rail, I think.
Yeah, you did. You did. I watched this clip earlier. You landed it.
So funny.
I was like not giving a fuck at that point. I was like, I was waiting to hit somebody. I know it's fucked up to say, but I was pissed.
I literally knew it. I was like, someone's going to catch his hands, bro. Yeah. Like, if they do some dumb shit. There was one guy who I literally had said that, or like Jordan had said some shit. He's like, someone's about to catch his hands. And literally, you're coming up, some dude snakes you, but he goes like, oh, my bad, bro. And I was like, that literally saved his life.
I was getting angry. Like,
it's understandable, bro. Like,
I mean, yeah, there's a lot of people there, but there's no reason to get that angry.
We're out here. I think the best thing about finally getting out here is like, I haven't been filming street clips like I my whole life since I've, it's like, yeah. I got a designated day. We're going out. We're getting active. We're filming, and it just feels good as fuck.
Yeah.
Getting shit done.
It's like, nothing's more satisfying than getting a clip at the end of the day. Like, you all know it's true. Yeah. We're all a little scooter narcs. I know everybody loves their own clips more than they like anybody else's. It's just.
Yeah, sometimes.
Feels good.
I like to watch other people's clips, though. Like, my girlfriend even talks about it. For sure. I spend too much time on Instagram watching other people's clips. Yeah. Like, real shit, I watched, like, a lot of Instagram clips. Like, I don't even remember half the shit that I watch, but I'll be on Instagram for, like, hours.
Like, just suck watching your ass in. Yeah, literally.
I watch everybody's
shit. That'd be interesting.
Just fuck the people who just like it and then skip it. I don't want your follow, bro. I want you to watch me. Yeah. Austin's like a big ass playground. Austin, Texas is probably one of my favorite places in the U.S. Honestly, I've never been to Dallas and traveled around too much. Been to Houston a good bit. Houston's dope as fuck if you're into cars.
H-town,
Houston's got the craziest car scene in the United States. It literally has. All right, when I went to Houston, I was with my friend Amir and Ahmad. Follow Go Do on Instagram. Because we really begin activated on that bitch. We went to Houston. That shit was crazy. Like, they got, like, truck scene. The fucking Miata scene. The Mopar scene. Fucking all. Anything. Any type of car. You. No, not any. But, like, they got all types of shit out there, bro.
Yeah.
Houston sick as fuck. Shout out.
Never mind. Shout out Houston. Shout out DJ Screw. Shout out Pimp C. Shout out Zero.
Oh, God.
Shout out Lil Flip. Shout out Big Mo.
Houston got the spots too, bro. Literally, I didn't bring my scooter when I went, and I regretted it so much because
Houston's sick.
Literally, they had so much shit, and it looked untouched.
Yeah.
You know?
A lot of it's grimy, kind of like the East Coast too. Dude, reminds me like of a little bit.
Around downtown Baton Rouge, there's like, it's weird. There's only like a certain amount of gyms. That are even worth a fuck to get a clip at for me, honestly.
Oh, gyms. Okay. Oh, good
spots.
Whenever y'all
come out, I definitely have a lot of spots up in my sleeve just from, not even from me, but from some, they got some pages and shit on Instagram. Cajun Crust. Shout out Ben.
Okay.
Cajun Crust. Look it up. They got a bunch of spots on there.
That's fire.
We'll be able to find a lot of shit.
You double click it?
Yeah.
Yeah, how do you like that slime setting?
I don't know, man.
It's going to be nice. It'll be better than your last one, because I think your last one...
matches the rag and the glasses, if you want to post up with it real quick.
Shout out Pag Juin once
real
again.
Slime hours.
Puffco sponsored this man. Literally, what the fuck are you doing?
He deserves it.
Tap me in.
This fool's active.
There you go.
Put him on a fucking...
Did she just vibrate?
Put his face solid. On the Puffco.
You ready to go?
Yeah.
You're getting active with it, bro. Yes, sir. We're hitting that one at 522 degrees for like 40 seconds. I may have to change it to a minute.
Sorry to pull so hard in the mic.
Dang. No, I think it'll sound cool.
Yeah, they probably think
it'll sound cool.
Just a bunch of crackheads.
Yeah.
Yeah. YouTube is gonna demonetize y'all. No, I'm straight.
I'm not ready for it.
Just wait, bro. I'm fucking gonna have just a fat jar one day, and I'll do like, I'll have Paxton put like a counter, and I'll just like see how many dabs I could hit in one podcast.
Straight up. Just literally just need to make one of you, Paxton, and like Josh just fucking mobbing the Puffco.
Oh God, we'll need the portable, we'll need like the charging base, because that bitch will run out of battery, I bet.
Yeah.
If we're really just running laps.
An hour long Puffco sesh?
Yeah. I might bury myself if I do that. Honestly.
It may be more of me and Josh.
I feel like I'm a little unbearable to talk to when I'm too faded.
But yeah, y'all need to come out to Louisiana. We got to text Matt tonight. Yeah. For real. I'm Matt
Ogle. Let's go get Matt tonight and hit a crawfish boil.
Yeah, bro. Literally. Like, we can go to BR in New Orleans. It's like, and I mean, they got Hammond, which is like another city that has some spots, but literally. New Orleans and Baton Rouge are like the two places that like, but it's a lot. It's like you have to drive to find a spot that's like dope as fuck. Yeah. You know, you have to drive.
Spot hunting.
You have to go spot hunting for real. Cause like, it's not just, it's Louisiana is like the dirtiest fucking state. I've been damn near to every part of the state and it's like in South, been like a bunch of cities and my city is the dirtiest fucking state. I don't care what y'all say. But, I mean, California's pretty dirty, too. Can't cap that one. Like,
yeah, L.A. right now is pretty musty. Dude,
yeah, I can't say that, though. L.A. is probably the dirtiest.
How are those hurricanes down there?
Oh, shit, we just had a hurricane, and it's like we just now recovered a lot of the shit.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Around, and if you go through Shreveport, which is, like, where you go to get into, if you're going to Dallas, you go through Shreveport, and, like, you literally, there's, like, still tarps on the houses from like 2 years ago when there was a hurricane.
Bro, I seen you like cleaning up down there.
Oh yeah,
going to the community after.
Yeah, bro, it'd be fucked up. We'd be doing we'd be helping people out. Like,
oh yeah,
I'd be like trimming trees and stuff. That's the most thing. Really, I'm not fixing no power lines. If it's I'm doing something to help somebody, it's like cutting some grass or cutting a fucking tree. Some lumberjack.
I just know Louisiana tends to get.
Dude, we are the most unlucky state.
Yeah.
Literally, when it comes to weather, we are the most unlucky state. Like,
it's crazy.
Some of the houses in my neighborhood have flooded like 5-6 times.
Yeah, like I remember Katrina from when it hit my area, but that shit was like probably 5 times as weak as when it hit y'all. Just because y'all sea level. I know that like,
whenever
it hit like a truck.
Yeah, you had to have a truck. That's truck season right there. You know what I'm saying? Big foes.
Yeah, bro.
But yeah. If you had that truck nation over there. Literally, everybody has a truck where I live.
Yeah.
If you ain't got a truck, you a fucking bust. You
need to be able to freestyle. If you ain't got a Tahoe or a truck. You need to freestyle on wheels a little bit.
Oh, yeah. Let's get it. But yeah, I'll do a freestyle to end it out. To end out the podcast.
You want to end it out?
If you want to take it.
Yeah, how long we been going, bro? I feel like we've been going for a minute. Huh?
Hour and 27.
Damn.
I know.
How long was yesterday's one?
About 2. But we didn't have the video going the whole time.
Oh, so yeah, just probably going to crop it to where the video is. Yeah.
Came out to. For this one or the last one?
The last
one. Okay, yeah. Cool.
No, we got the video for this one.
Yeah, but Katrina's fucked up. About to end this bitch.
Yeah.
We literally housed like fucking 300 people in a shelter that we had.
It's crazy. I just seen you out there like doing community work.
Be out there
helping out your community.
That was the last time some shit happened. I was out there cleaning it up. We literally like during the flood, we were driving like a boat. We were driving boats over houses, like in trailer parks and stuff, like saving people off the top of their houses and shit.
Yeah,
like they had the. What do they call it? It's like the Cajun Army or something like that. And like literally it's just like I was on like the newspaper out there. It was like just a picture of me and like my brother-in-law's and like another friend of ours just like helping people off this like roads that are like flooding, like houses and shit.
Okay.
That are like saving people off the top of their houses.
Jesus.
It'd be weird and shit. It's super crazy.
Cool.
God bless.
Yeah.
That was years ago. Ain't nothing like that happened again. But yeah, we finna head out. I don't give a fuck about no clout. Bitch, I do grout around toilets.
Yeah.
I don't fuck with a mouse. I don't fuck with a rat. I'm on this beat. You know, I kill a cat. I kill a cat like I'm in a race. I do the race. I ain't take K, but I will take your bait.
Cut it.
That out. Cut the shit.
And he's gone.
Just like that, our first walkout.
First walkout.
Get your money, not your funny. Who said it best? Your boy Swamp Daddy.
Y'all gonna stop playing with my name. I ain't gonna say it no more.
Oh God, he don't wanna hear it. I don't wanna hear it. Twisted T holler at us. Episode 2, we out.
Swamp Daddy, everybody.
We out.
Josiah Atwell. Have a good one.
Hey.
Oh God.